Okay, so it is a great day at KISS in my girl crush diary because solo star via Texas and Hadley Street is in the building. Solange, how are you?
I'm great.
You must be feeling great. Are you on a high from last night? Because your gig was killer. I loved it.
Thank you so much. That means so much to me. I had a great time doing it.
It was amazing to watch you come out, actually, because I was standing right by the side of the stage with my girls. And as you came out, your face was a little bit like... Is it a bit overwhelming, the reception you get here?
It doesn't matter how many times you perform right before. I think every artist has that moment of, wow, this is really happening. Mm-hmm. And that certainly was in full effect for me yesterday.
Does it feel good to have such a positive reception outside of the States?
It does. I mean, you really never know what to expect. Mm-hmm. We booked the show before the EP came out, so we had no idea what to expect. And the fact that both of the shows sold out, I think like in an hour, it just is so humbling and I feel so very lucky.
Oh, totally. Well, people were singing your songs word for word out there, man.
Yes, and even songs off of my first album, which was like 11 years ago.
Yeah.
So it's kind of insane to see.
Me and my friends, we thought you were going to bring Noriega out for feeling you. She's going to bring him out. But it's cool though. We were happy with Crush.
Thank you.
I love the show Girls. And the new season premiered recently. And they were playing Losing You in the background. Was that a little moment for you?
It was really, definitely a little moment for me. I got to go and see the premiere.
Wicked.
And I met Lena, who's the writer.
Golden Globe winner.
And actress and producer, et cetera, et cetera. Mm-hmm. She's amazing. And it's really nice to see a girl my age sort of taking the reins of her career. It's really inspirational.
And now your music and her TV show have met, which is cool, man.
Yeah, it is. It's really awesome.
Well, for people that don't know, you've been making music for a minute now, because you're 26 now, but you've been making music since you were 15. We had the solo Soul album, we had Soul Angel and the Hadley Street Dreams, my personal favourite. And now we've got this, the True EP, which is just gorgeous. I mean, the last album, that was a proper throwback to like the 50s, 60s, like proper doo-wop sound, like Motown influence. But this is just like pure 80s throwback. Like when I was listening to it, I was hearing like Cyndi Lauper, Madonna.
Yeah, definitely.
Like what kind of drew you back to that era?
Actually, you know, before I started to make the record, mm-hmm. I made a playlist of a bunch of records that I really just admire. And it wasn't even sonically that I wanted to achieve what they achieved. I definitely wanted to create something of my own. Mm-hmm. But I think what I loved about 80s pop music is it was solid pop music. It felt good. It was danceable. It was just feel-good music. But the intricacies and the layers that went into the production and the melodies and the lyrics, you know, they were a lot deeper than at first thought. And also extremely bold and adventurous. You know, a lot of the songs from the 80s were 6 and 7 minute longs, and these were songs that were top 40 records.
Mm-hmm.
So I just wanted to kind of make an interesting pop record.
Well, you've definitely done that. Because I think the great thing about this EP is that even though the beats are quite happy and sonically, it's very like summery. Like when I first heard Losing You, I was like, you know what? This sounds like tropical fruit juice.
Okay.
That's the vibe I kind of got.
Like
but
that.
The lyrics are quite dark on the whole EP. Like you deal with a lot of like heartbreak issues and things, insecurities that you've been through and stuff. Was that what you were just trying to get out there? Like, you know what? You can still feel sad, but to a good...
Before I started to write the record, I was in a really, really good place in my relationship.
Mm-hmm.
As I'm sure you know, Solo Star and Hadley drew from a lot of pain and heartbreak as well.
Mm-hmm.
And I've always been able, from a writer's standpoint, to draw from those sort of things very, very easily and very instinctually. And so for this record, I was like in a happy relationship.
Yeah.
My son had just started school. My life was in a good place. And Dev came down and he was going through a breakup actually and we became really, really good friends and I sort of was always the voice of reason, the woman's perspective in his relationship. And so a lot of that started to seep through in the songwriting process. And then there are also songs about my relationship now, like Don't Let Me Down, which is... It talks about it in a positive light, but there still are those moments where you're like, is this too good to be true?
Mm-hmm.
Someone's about to F up something.
Yeah. You know? So is that what inspired the title of the EP? Like, is it too good to be true, hence?
Well, no, actually, I think this was just like one of the most honest reflections of where I am now. And that that sort of brought on the title.
Cool. Well, you mentioned Dev Hynes, aka Blood Orange. Now, we know him from being in the group called Testicicles originally in the UK, who like they had a strong minute.
Yes.
Now, you and Dev, you have this kind of musical love affair, I guess, similar, I don't know, to Khalees when she started out with the Neptunes or Janet with like Jimmy Jam. And how did that? How did this musical love affair begin with you and Dev?
We actually worked together on Theophilus London, flying overseas.
Wicked.
And it just was one of those things that the chemistry was there immediately. It was very natural and second nature for us to create music together. And I think for me as a songwriter, it's, and for lots of songwriters, it puts you in an extremely vulnerable state to sit in a room with someone that you don't know that well and open up your heart and your emotions. And there's definitely this sense of like not wanting to say anything that sounds corny or cheesy and being worried that the other person might think that. But with him, you know, as soon as he would play tracks, I just would have so much to draw from. And melodically and lyrically, it just came out of me. And I never, ever had that sense of like, okay, I have this lyric idea, you know, having to put out the disclaimer first. So I think, you know, it just is a really, really beautiful organic evolution.
Yeah.
Of us working together, and it's been such a joy. And when I think back, and that was definitely intentional for me to find someone that I had that chemistry with.
Yeah.
And he was not the first person. I worked with about three or four producers before that I tried out, and he was just the fourth person, person coming in that week, and I didn't know what to expect. And I intentionally wanted that because of what you noticed. Some of my favorite albums, from Janet Control to Khalees' record to A-Marie and Rich Harrison to Justin and Pharrell. I think when you have that chemistry, it really shines through.
Absolutely.
And I wanted to achieve that, so I was happy that he was the guy.
So you've got your musical man now.
Yeah.
You and Dev forever. I mean, but it's a beautiful thing. And the thing I have to talk about is your dance routines as well.
My dance routines.
You and Dev's dance routines. Because we were trying to emulate them yesterday in the space. We couldn't really do it. And I really would love you just to teach me one.
I will teach you
Can you
one.
Do that?
I
okay,
would.
I've got Lucy and you queued up right now.
Oh, my God.
Can you come around?
Okay.
And can we have a dance moment? Okay.
We're going to crank this up.
Okay, look. Okay.
So all of the dance routines are sort of make-up
bars.
Okay.
Okay.
But there's one that goes cross, two, jump.
Right.
Cross,
two, three, jump.
Right.
Okay. The next. Okay. I think we can do that. Let's go. One, two, three. Right. Left.
You did it.
Oh,
you did it.
Okay. Let me have one more go. Let's try one more. Thank you very much, Solange. Thank you very much. I mean, it's quite interesting what's happened with you over the past 12 to 18 months, because it just seems like the fashion world's falling over you. And people that I wouldn't typically assume would be a fan of your type of R&B or whatever genre they want to put your music in are suddenly like, oh my God, I love Solange.
Yeah.
Now, is there a little bit of you that's like, hang on a minute, where were you when I was putting out Solo Star and singing Feeling You?
For me, it's such a beautiful thing to be introduced to a new audience and anyone who has a love and respect for the music. That's what you make it for, to sort of grow into that evolution. I think the only time that I feel a little sensitive about it is when my past work is not respected as much when it's written and contextualized. Because there are people like yourself, and there are people like people who were at the show last night who knew every word to Crush, knew every word to Tony.
Yeah.
And so to sort of downplay those songs is not fair at all.
Yeah.
Because people, you know, felt a genuine connection to them, and I did as well. But it's such a wonderful, wonderful feeling to be able to expand and introduce people to a new sound. It's been such a great journey.
Now, this is only the EP, seven songs long.
Yes.
So what about the full album? And is it going to be called True as well?
No, it's not going to be true. It's going to be its own entire entity. Mm-hmm. I'm starting to write the songs now.
Right.
So I would say maybe a year from now, right, you guys will be able to hear it. But it's the really, really early stages. And I'm doing it a little different than I have my other records, which is writing the songs before any music is in
okay.
place. So,
right.
It's going to be an interesting ride for me because I've never done it before. But I think lyrically, there's so much that I want to attack and address. Mm-hmm. And it has to start there. And so it'll be a cool ride.
Well, I'm sure you've got a lot of new stories to tell because it's been 4 years yeah. since the last album came out. Yeah. And Jules, he's like eight now, right?
Eight
now, people
old.
That don't know Jules, I like to call him the artist formerly known as The Bump in the Destiny's Child Soldier video. How is he?
Oh, my God, that's hilarious. I might just start calling him
Why not?
That. He's great.
Yeah?
He has grown into such an awesome young man. Mm-hmm. I'm so in love with that boy. And he's coming tomorrow.
Oh, wicked.
Paris, so I can't wait to see him.
Do you play him your music?
Oh, yeah. He's involved in the whole thing.
Right.
He has his opinions.
Do you listen to them?
I do, actually. Mm-hmm. Before I started working on True, I was working on another record, mm-hmm. which I decided that was just too dark for me at the time.
Uh-huh.
He actually wrote some of the chords to
okay.
the song. Yeah, he's really ill on the piano.
Wicked. Yeah. So if he wanted to pursue a career in this industry,
I'd
would...
be terrified.
Yeah, really?
But you know yeah. what? Whatever he wants to do, I'm gonna, you know, be right behind him and foster that.
Absolutely.
But I am praying, you know, that this is not what he wants to do. In the same way that my mom prayed that I didn't want to do this.
It turned out all right for Miss Tina.
I know. But I definitely feel like it's, you know, it's a hard journey. It's a lot of hard work. Mm-hmm. It's a lot of sacrifice. Mm-hmm. And I think there's a part of you as a mother that always wants your kid to, like, grow up and be a lawyer or a doctor or
yeah, yeah.
something with some structure and stability.
Jules the dentist.
I know. I'd be into that. I'd be so into that.
I mean, just mentioning fashion because I can't, like... get away from this outfit you got on today. I mean, everyone is obsessed with what you wear
you
at the moment.
Great style
oh, thanks.
Well.
You know, I try. I like a little print
no,
here and there.
You look great.
Thanks. Oh, it's long so that you like my shirt.
But you ladies, you look awesome too.
Oh, thanks. We're trying out here. We're trying. It's the London style. I mean, do you like a lot of London fashion? Do you get inspired from here?
I do. I also love that you're able to have that kind of accessibility
mm-hmm.
To great fashion at a great price here.
Oh, yeah.
In the States, it's a lot harder to find that mm-hmm. kind of versatility. And I think you guys call them high street.
Yeah, high street. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Which is basically like... Top
shop. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay, got it. I'm learning my term.
Hey, look, there you go. You're yeah. down. You're getting it. The high street. Would you ever bring out your... I know you've been attached to other fashion brands and the House yeah. of Darien obviously exists, but would you ever do your thing like as a side project to that? Just your own stuff
well,
completely?
Actually, it's interesting because Wikipedia just starts so many rumors, but I never, ever was a part of the design team
okay.
behind House of Darien.
All right, okay.
I just did a photo shoot for them mm-hmm. once. I've never really been interested in like... being a designer and having my own line.
Yeah.
Probably because I see how much hard work and dedication mm-hmm. it takes. And I really, really, you know, consider myself a singer and songwriter
yeah.
first, a musician and artist first. But there's definitely a part of me that feels like I have ideas to contribute mm-hmm. and I'm always picking up things from traveling and textiles
yeah.
and color and ways. And so if there was ever an opportunity to collaborate with the right folks, then mm-hmm. I would super be into that.
This is a cool. Who's your favorite designer?
Probably Kenzo, and I'm actually yeah. really good friends with the designer.
So oh, wicked.
That would be ideal.
You need to make that happen, man.
Yeah,
get on it.
One thing at a time around here.
It was true. Well, I know as music obviously is your heart and you DJ a lot.
Yes.
Now, I watched one of your DJ sets on the internet and you dropped Katie B on a mission,
I
which
did.
Is a tune. And we love Katie B in the UK.
Yeah,
so
she's awesome. I actually was introduced to her by one of my friends in the XX who
oh, okay.
was always sending me music, Oliver. And I love that song and I love her record and her voice. And she actually has tweeted, you know,
she loves your music, yeah.
Record, so it's definitely a mutual love. She's a talented lady.
She is. What other UK artists are you switched on to at the moment?
Jesse Ware, I think, is really awesome. Right now, I'm like so immersed into this artist, James Mason.
Okay.
From the 70s. And I've been listening to a lot of New Orleans bounce music.
Okay.
Yeah. Since I'm writing, I try not to be too immersed into newer music, because it's really easy subconsciously to sort of
absolutely
let that stuff in. But I've been jamming Donny Hathaway and James Mason, and I'm on my stuff right now.
you're a throwback soul at heart, right?
I am.
Definitely.
I am.
Well, I mean, the music that we're loving off this EP is just, for me, it just sounds perfect for summer, even though it came out in November.
I know.
It sounds so summery. So are you going to come back and perform in the summer? Are you doing any festivals or anything like that?
I'm actually going to come back here for Field Day.
Wicked.
So that should be fun. I am told my manager to get me on as many festivals as possible, because
cool.
I have a lot of scantily clad outfits I'm trying to bring out.
Look, that's summer shorts. That's what it's all about, right?
Yes, yes. And now that I've lived in New York, you know, I used to live in LA for off and on for 9 years.
Mm-hmm.
And so every day was an opportunity to wear shorts. And so it's been hard switching over to New York and
being in London.
Like 2 months, yes.
Sorry about that.
Yeah.
It's quite cold.
Yeah, it is cold.
And I mean, I think words can take on different meanings every day, the same word. So right now in your life, what does the word true mean to you now?
I think even mentioning what I was talking about earlier, just being in sort of the most open and honest place in my life and my career, in motherhood, in my relationship. I really feel like I'm in that true essence of myself, and that evolution has been really, really powerful for me. So
beautiful. Well, you do seem really comfortable with yourself.
Thank you.
That's the one thing I'm getting. I mean, obviously, I think it's interesting to have watched you grow as an artist, because you've been doing this thing since you were 15. And obviously, you know, people can't mention you without mentioning the other Knowles,
right,
kind of thing.
Course.
But it seems like you've really stepped into your own now. And people are like, you know what? Like, she's not just X person. Sister, she is Solange. And do you feel confident in that statement now?
Yeah, I mean, I absolutely never felt that way about myself.
Mm-hmm.
But I also think it's important to highlight, you know, I'm 26 now.
Mm-hmm.
And when you're 15 and when you're 19 and 21, you go through so many different phases of your life. And most people sort of step into artistry in their late 20s or their mid 20s.
Mm.
And I had the gift and the curse to be able to start and sort of live that out very publicly.
Mm.
So it's really a great feeling to now be in a position where I am a woman and I am in that place in my life. So it's a good situation.
We are loving your situation.
Yeah.
Solange, thank you so much for hanging out with Kiss.
Thank you so much.
Hopefully see you soon.
And practice those moves.
I will. Trust me. I'm going to be practicing tonight, man.
All right,
thank you.
Thank you.